Hello students, chapter 1, The Living World, video 3. Today we are going to talk about taxonomic categories. In video 2, I had told you, discussed about classification. Children, classification is not a single step. Rather, it involves hierarchy of steps in which each step represents a rank or a category. Let us understand this. What does it mean? See, if you can see this, this is a hierarchy, taxonomic hierarchy, where if we go in the ascending manner, species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, kingdom. Species is the lowest category and kingdom is the highest category. How do we remember it? We remember it by a trick. Some girls from our class play kabaddi. I repeat, some girls from our class play kabaddi. Some S species, G genus, from F family, O order, class, play P phylum, K kabaddi, kingdom. Each is a category. Species is a category, genus is a category, family is a category, order is a category, class is a category, phylum is a category, and kingdom is a category. And when they are arranged in this form, it is known as taxonomic hierarchy. Now, let's come back again to here. Now, each category is referred to as unit of classification. That means species is a unit of classification, genus, family, order, class, each is a unit of classification. It represents a rank and is commonly termed as taxon. Students, there is a slight difference between taxon and category. Taxon, I had talked about taxon in the last video. If you have seen my video, taxon, I told you, rice, mammal, dog, cat, each is a taxon belonging to different levels. Now, taxon deals with object. Category deals with ranking, like species is a rank, genus is a rank. So taxon is a real term, category is a abstract term. Category, taxon may belong to any ranking, category belongs to a particular ranking. Now let us discuss each category and understand each category. So we start with the smallest category, the lowest category, that is the species. Now, how do we define what is species? Species is a group of individual organism with fundamental similarities. A group of individual organism with fundamental similarities is known as species. Now you should know that one species is distinguished from the other closely related species. There are two species, one species A and species B. They both are closely related. How can you distinguish the two? They can be distinguished based on morphological differences. Like for example, there is Magnifera indica. This is the scientific name of mango. Magnifera belongs to genus. Indica is the specific epithet. Same way, another example, Solanum tuberosum, common name of potato. Solanum is the genus. Tuberosum is the specific epithet. Same way, Panthera leo. Panthera is the genus and leo is the specific epithet or the species, which common name lion. So one genus, children, can have more than one specific epithet. That means one genus can have more than one species. Like for example, genus Panthera. Genus Panthera is having three species, three specific epithet: tiger, lion and leopard. Tiger, Panthera tigris, lion, Panthera leo, leopard, Panthera pardus. Like Solanum includes two species, Solanum nigrum and Solanum melongiana. Solanum melangiana is brinjal. Humans name is what? Homo sapiens. Homo is the genus and sapiens is the specific epithet. Now, let's come to genus. Genus comprises a group of related species that has more character in common in comparison to species of other genera. Now, if you have two genera, two genus, then all the species belonging to one genus will have more common characters as compared to the other genus. Suppose there are two genus, one Panthera, another Felis. Under Panthera, genus Panthera, there are three species I told you just now, Panthera leo, Panthera pardus and Panthera tigris. If you see to these three species, they will have common, more common features as compared to another genus, that is Felis. This genus Felis includes cats. Now let's come to the third category, that is the family. Now what is family? It is a group of related genera. All the related genera together comes in one family. Like I just now told, there are two genus, Panthera and Felis. In Panthera comes lion, tiger, leopard. In genus Felis includes cats. Like genus Felis includes two species. Felis domestica, that is the common cat, and Felis bengalensis, that is the leopard cat. Here you can see. I have written it with red pen. Now that means we have two genus. One is Panthera, another Felis. Both these genus belong to a family known as Felidae. Both the genus Panthera and Felis belongs to genus Felidae. Now there is one more family, that is Canidae. Family Canidae has dogs. So there are two families, one is Felidae, one is Canidae. Same way, if you talk about Solanum, genera, we had talked about genus Solanum, same way there can be three genus, Solanum, Petunia, Datura. These three genus belong to the family Solanaceae. Now, look here. I have tried to explain over here. Let us first take order. What is the next category? Order. What is order? Order is species, genus, family. Altogether, they come into a higher taxonomic category, which is known as order. So order, being the higher taxonomic category, is the assemblage of families. All the families come together form what? Order. Like there are families Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae, which belongs to order Polymoniales. Same way, just now I had talked about family Felidae and Canidae. It belongs to order Carnivora. So look here, I have tried to explain you with the help of a flowchart. Order Carnivora. It is having two families, Felidae and Canidae. Talking about Felidae, there are two genus we have studied, Panthera and Felis. Panthera has three species, Panthera leo, Panthera tigris, Panthera pardus. Felis has two species, Felis domestica and Felis bengalensis. So next higher category is class. All orders together comprises the class. We have just now studied about an order Carnivora. Same way, there is another order Primata. This order Primata includes monkey, gorilla, gibbon. Now order primata and order carnivora, they both belong to class mammalia. So next higher category, that is phylum. Talking about phylum, all classes together comes under phylum. Classes like fishes, amphibians, reptile, birds and mammals. These are the five classes. Coming into phylum Chordata. What is the characteristics of Chordata? You have studied in class 9. The features like presence of notochord, dorsal hollow neural system. Children, in phylum is for animals, and for plants this category is known as division. If you remember, you had studied the division under plant kingdom: thallophyta, bryophyta, pteridophyta, gymnosperms, angiosperms. So they are the divisions. And phylum also you have studied the different phylums: Porifera, Coelenterata, and then there were many other. Now the two phylums, phylum Animalia, all the phylums of animals, they come under kingdom. Same way plants division comes under kingdom. Kingdom is the highest category. So there are two kingdoms: kingdom Animalia and kingdom Plantae. So student, this is a hierarchical category. That's a broad category. In class 11th also we study only the broad category. But if you in higher classes in college, you will study about subcategories. These each category have subcategories, but at your level we do not have subcategories. Now let us look at this table. What is this table denoting? Common name, biological name, genus, family, order, class, phylum and division. Like man, Homo sapiens, genus Homo, family Hominidae, order Primata, class Mammalia, phylum Chordata. Housefly, biological name Musca domestica, genus Musca, family Muscidae, order Diptera, class Insecta, and phylum Arthropoda. Mango, Magnifera indica, genus Magnifera, family Encardiaceae, order Sapindales, class Dicotyledoni, division Angiospermae. I did not call it phylum. Wheat, Triticum, Astivum, genus Triticum, family Poaceae, order Poales, class Monocotyledoni, division Angiosperm. I hope you have understood about the different categories.